So let's now go ahead and talk about what these interblock terms might look like. And then we'll come back and conclude with the boundary conditions. So again, right, we had t to the I plus a half, for example, is equal to k I plus a half a I plus a half over now we already have a definition for delta x I plus a half because it came from the definition of the central difference in the pressure gradient. But, you know, in terms of the other guys, K, A, we haven't defined these, what these might be. So for the time being, let's just look at one of them in isolation. So let's look at just the permeability. So assume A, delta X, and mu are constant throughout the reservoir, so that then our T I plus a half just becomes K I plus a half A over B alpha mu delta X. If we look at two grid blocks, let's say that goes from I to I plus 1, where K at I is not equal to K at I plus 1. So we have some heterogeneity in the permeability. Okay. What we can do is we can say that, you know, we can assume that there's some flux going from I to I plus 1 Q. And that flux, just according to Darcy's law and our definition of transmissibility, in this case, right? So remember, the transmissibility is the fluid property that allows transfer fluid from one grid block to the next, or the set of fluid and reservoir properties that define the transmissibility of fluid from one reservoir to the next. So in our definition here, this flux, according to Darcy's law, would be the transmissibility times the pressure times the pressure difference between the two grid blocks. And then we can solve for this pressure difference, right? So solve for the pressure difference leads to the equation to that equation. And so now what we're going to do, and this is where, you know, we're introducing some approximation to the theory, because strictly speaking, this entire grid block has one pressure, and the pressure is discontinuous at the grid block boundary. Okay, but let's look at the pressure drop between these points here, right? So if we have a point I plus a half, and a point I plus 1, right? Then let's assume that we can split up the pressure drop such that we have P at I plus a half minus P at I plus P at I plus 1 minus P at I plus a half, right? So this is equivalent to saying p at I plus 1 minus p at I, right? And we know that that's equal to, you know, that's equal to this term up here, right? But if we were to write the flux from in each of these half grid blocks, right? So the permeability in this shaded region here is just ki, and the permeability in this region here is just ki plus 1, right? So if we split up the contribution to the flux in terms of both of them, right, we have q mu over 2 ki a plus q mu . Now you notice these have 2 in them, and the 2 comes from the fact that these grid blocks, this distance here is delta x over 2, right? Again, delta x being a constant between the two grid blocks for now, right? So that's delta x over 2 in both cases. And so, you know, this term corresponds to that. This term corresponds to that, right? And the addition of these two, we already said, the addition of these two corresponds to this, and this corresponds to that, right? So, if we set that equal to q . So then if we solve this equation for ki plus 1, you'll see that most of the terms cancel each other. And then what you get is ki plus a half, rather, that's what we're solving for, is equal to 1 over ki plus 1 over ki plus 1 inverse. Ah, 2. There's a 2 there up front. So that is our ki plus a half. This is our interblock transmissibility. And this is called the harmonic average. Harmonic average. This is called the harmonic average, and what this does is it allows that if either of the permeabilities in grid block I or grid block I plus 1 were to be 0, then if the permeability in a grid block was 0, that means that there's no ability for fluid to move into that grid block, effectively making the fluid flux across this boundary 0. And using the harmonic average ensures that that will in fact be the case. The interblock permeability will be 0 in the event that either one of the grid blocks I or I plus 1 is 0. And that has an advantage, of course, over, you know, just using the regular arithmetic mean, which would be just the average of the two grid blocks. Because if one of them were 0, then the grid block, the average value at the interface would be half, right? Half of. So again, let's just show that. Let's just write it out. So if we assume the arithmetic mean, then we'd have just the average, right? K plus ki plus 1 over 2. Let's assume that ki plus 1 is 0. then we'd have just ki over 2. And that would mean that there's actually fluid flux into a grid block that has zero permeability, which wouldn't make physical sense. So using the harmonic average ensures that there's no, in the event that one of them is zero, that there's no fluid flow from one grid block to the next. Okay, so this would be the case where if you only had a heterogeneous permeability and all the other terms were constant. But we can use these same arguments to describe things more generally. So for example, in the event if A is constant, let's say only A and mu are constant. If only A and mu are constant, now we already have a definition for delta xi plus a half, right? Delta xi plus delta xi plus 1 all over 2. Then, using the same logic as before, what we would arrive at is for the harmonic mean, we'd have that guy. And then finally, in the most general case, and in this class, we'll only allow, we're not going to deal with heterogeneous fluid properties right now, only heterogeneous reservoir properties. So we'll always assume that mu and B alpha are constants for now, because we're just talking about a single phase fluid, Newtonian fluid, if you will. And so, if, say, mu is a constant, only mu is a constant, then what we might define is Ka over delta x all to the I plus a half to be equal to, and again, this just follows from the same arguments that we made earlier on the previous slide. And then, in this case, we'd have t to the I plus a half is equal to 1 over b alpha mu times ka delta x I plus a half. So that would be the interbolic transmissibility for the case where all three ka and delta x were heterogeneous.